if you compare boys and girls when it comes to growth, they follow slightly different paths, and that's why now we even have vaccination charts. Vaccination and growth charts have, there's a different chart for boys and there's a different chart for girls. Boys will tend to put on weight faster, so their physical growth is faster than girls. They'll put on weight faster, they'll grow taller faster, they'll have slightly bigger head circumferences. But then you sometimes notice that the milestone achievement for boys and girls, especially when it comes to socialization, like moving around, talking, there's a slight difference. So that boys might tend to lag behind girls, sometimes by like 3 to 6 months when it comes to like willingness to socialize, walking sometimes, and talking. The major difference is talking, that boys will tend to take longer to talk than girls. Of course, that is affected by other factors. The more children a child is in contact with, let's say the more children under the age of 5 that a child is in contact with, when they are learning how to speak, the faster they speak. So let's say a first child in a family, a first boy in a family that has no other children and they don't have children that they're interacting with, might take longer to speak than a second boy in that same family. Or a boy who has an older sister might speak faster than a boy who has an older brother. Because girls are more social. Okay. Now, because of autism now has become a major problem in our times, either because we diagnose it better and earlier, or maybe there's things in our environment that might be causing autism. It is important to point it out clearly to parents that as it stands, there's no evidence that suggests that vaccination causes autism. Nevertheless, we are seeing more cases of autism now than we did before. And we're also seeing more and more children coming in with speech disorders, difficulties in learning. And because of, in that setting, the worry is that the longer we wait, the more difficult intervention will be, and the less success that intervention is going to give. So it means our threshold of saying that maybe this child needs to be assessed might go down. Previously, we used to say if a child hasn't spoken by 3 years, maybe that's time to worry. But what I've seen is a boy or girl who has not said a single word by 2 years, you might actually consider having them assessed, because there are several things that the child could be suffering from. The child could be having problems with hearing. If you can't hear, you can't talk, you know, because the way you learn how to talk is by mimicking. So if you can't hear clearly, the child might actually hear well enough to follow instructions, but they can't make out words clearly for them now to mimic those words, to repeat them back. Then secondly is that with all of these screens that we are seeing, a lot of children end up preferring to interact with screens as opposed to talking to people. So it might be difficult to tell whether that child actually has a learning disability or it is the amount of screen time that they're getting. Again, it is important to point out to parents that limit the amount of TV, tablet, phones, YouTube that your child is doing until they learn how to talk. Because before they learn how to talk, TV and YouTube is slowing down their acquisition of speech. No one learns how to speak from TV. It sometimes appears that they learn how to speak from TV, but it's only because they've already learned how to speak, so they can pick up other language from TV. But before you learn how to speak, TV is slowing down your acquisition of speech. Now, the third one is that they could have a learning disorder, dyslexia, they could have autism, they could have Asperger's, which impairs their social functioning. And in that setting, an assessment and diagnosis allows that child to be put on the right therapy that will allow them to pick up speech. So I would ask any parents who, your child is getting to 2 years, they don't seem to have picked up language, they need to be assessed, because, for example, rickets can also cause a slowdown in mental development. So it might be something as simple as, you know, you treat the rickets and the child will pick up. Other than that, you know, boys and girls, their interests are different. You find that boys enjoy more violent games. Girls might be more interested. But again, those are generalizations. Every child is an individual. And learning what works for your child, what your child is interested in, also allows you to improve their learning. Because children learn better when they find themselves in environments that are stimulating. So finding out what works for your child is great, and also constantly speak to your child. One of the reasons why children take longer to speak now than they did before is because parents themselves are caught up in screen time all the time. They're on their phones, they are watching television, the house helps are on their phones or watching television. So the children are being left to their own devices. And then we are surprised when they don't speak. The only way they learn how to speak is by us speaking to them. So that's something to encourage. Let's talk to our children.